if you've never been lonely, you don't realise what it is like.
It feels as though you've been dumped in the deep end and there's nobody there to rescue you.
Well, you go hours and hours, never speak to anybody.
I don't think you'll ever get used to it. You know, it's always loneliness. If you go out, you come back, and you come back to an empty house, you know, and it's loneliness again. And you're always waiting for somebody to call.
We started our project by gathering data from interviews and focus groups. And from the user's input, we found out that what they needed was an easy-to-use telepresence system to communicate with their loved ones. So we created EasyTalk. We got straight to work sketching several design alternatives, all of which used a screen and a camera to provide video communication. We used two of the sketches to go further and create some low-fidelity prototypes. One of them was a concept using tangible blocks representing contacts to be called and could be placed on a base to place a video call. The other design was based on an old telephone. We took these designs back to our users and evaluated them to see which one would be best for them. We had a clear winner, which was the tangible blocks. Working further with the concept, we conducted blind tests with users to find the most suitable material to make our blocks with. Then we began building. The main component of EasyTalk is an Arduino Uno. Additionally, we used two push buttons, an RFID reader, an RFID card, an RFID tag, and a LED diode. We started by connecting all the parts. We then wrote Arduino code, as well as processing code, to control the video calling software on the computer. When all of that was working, we started designing and making the base to hold all the components and the blocks which would contain the RFID tags. We used mostly wood and laser cutting techniques to build our final prototype. The Arduino was placed in the base container, which is also where the buttons were fit in. The RFID sensor was connected to the Arduino and attached to the lid of the base, along with the LED diode. The final blocks were wooden cubes, and the RFID tags were placed inside. Each block represents a unique person that can be called, and placing the block on the base immediately places a video call to that person. A blinking LED light gives feedback to show that the block has been correctly placed. Taking the block off ends the call. Placing a different block on the base will call the other person. To receive a call on EasyTalk, you can press the green answer button. To reject a call or to hang up, you can press the red button. That's how easy it is.